Ahoy, mateys! This be the Playing Dutchman, and we're continuing Night in the Woods. Last night we went and got into the Historical Society with Angus. We're going to go on an adventure again today. We had a very weird dream to end it off with. Morning at the Pickaxe Sphere in Town Center today. I don't even know why I'm saying this. You're in Town Center every day. Anyway, see you later.
Hey, dude. At the old Snalkin. Come save me from boredom supreme. Sincerely, Gregory.
Oh, shit. Not what I meant to do.
Away message. Planet are to be pitified as they cannot know how big and cool they are. Oh, wait. That's one we already had.
Cool. Let's go downstairs, say hi to Mom, explore town, and do some more crimes. Well, no, the park is up. It's public, so it's probably not a crime. Nope. Don't need to see that. Bird, I kind of get you now. All, like, trapped and shit. I should let you out. Nah. That's just mean towards the bird. Don't act like you're contemplating its freedom and then be like, nah. Mean.
Honey, you okay?
Mornings are tough right now.
Are you pregnant?
No!
Oh, honey, is that why you came home?
No, not at all!
Sweetie, you can tell me. I've been there. And despite nature's intentions, God came through and blessed us with you. You were a miracle, baby.
That's me.
A miracle. After all the miscarriages, we've given up hope. We'd given up hope. And then there you were.
And here I am now.
So if you're pregnant...
I am not pregnant. I was not in a situation where pregnancy happens.
Okay, okay. I just want you to know that you can always come to us with this.
Okay, noted. Can we talk about anything else?
Sure. You know, if you did have a baby...
Okay! I'm out!
Okay, sweetie. I'm sorry, I get excited about grandbabies.
It's fine. I'll be back later.
Love you.
Love you too.
If it was a boy, you could name him Kelvin.
Oh God, Mom!
If it was a girl, you could name her...
Trash Baby! Cordelia!
Why don't I just have this baby and hand it to you?
Ooh! Okay, bye, I'm leaving.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Talking about babies, nothing more uncomfortable in the fucking world.
My girlfriend knows what's up. Love you, honey.
Yeah, no, I have a supreme... No, I wouldn't say hatred for children.
I can tolerate them if they're well-behaved. I'm uncomfortable around them. I don't know. It's,
complicated. Not really. I don't like kids.
There's some kids I do. I can like. Like, again, well-behaved. My girlfriend has a nephew and a niece. They were pretty well-behaved. They were fun to hang around with, but... Ah, fuck. Screen. But yeah. Otherwise, I don't see why I would... I think I have too many ambitions to want kids ever. And there's nothing in the world that can convince me that ambitions and having children are not mutually exclusive. I'm very stubborn about this point. See if Mr. Chezukov is standing. Yes, he is. Let's get some stars in our faces. Be as this dude right outside her window. constantly. Arnold's stalker bound. Hello, B, did you get my texts? Oh god, that's sad and funny. Sup, Chezikov? May! Mr. Chezikov! You look a bit worse for wear today, May. Oh, I'm fine. I made it up here, didn't I? Watch yourself, lest you fall. Will do. Here to see some stars? You know it. Come have a look. Please don't blind myself. Okay, I'm not even complaining about it anymore. I just know this is a thing that will always happen when I try and look at stars. Okay, hang on. Probably not those. Oh, hey. Yeah! Gotcha! Ooh, which one is this? Adena Astra. You know this one? Yes! Yes, I know this one! It's a common story. How Adena journeyed to the frozen lake. How she traversed unknown faraway lands. I was very into Adena stories when I was a kid. So you must know what became of her. Yeah. How she, in her quest, turned her back on the sky and journeyed down into the earth, where her stars were no longer over her head, and how she was never seen again? Yeah. Whatever. Is that not a sad ending? No, disappearing isn't the same as dying. She probably went somewhere else completely. And did all kinds of cool shit. Oh my. Yeah, so, whatever. I can hope. You can't stop me from dreaming. Okay, let's traverse the parts of the sky we haven't before. No. There's a pretty big empty fucking place here. There's the lying down dude. It's probably not here. Oh. Yes! I think I got one. Let us see. Ferdinand the Mountaineer. Ferdinand. It's a fun name. It is. So what's up with this guy? Ferdinand was from a flatland. This Midwest? Whatever the Midwest or wherever he was from was. Every place has a Midwest. This is true. He dreamed of mountains and devoted his life to climbing them. Because his hometown was flat. Isn't this a common instinct? To seek that which is unlike where one grows up? Yeah. I mean, people go to the city a lot. Like, they move there because it's got stuff. And there's more people like them, maybe. Sucks though, not everyone can just up and leave. When I left my country, I felt the same thing. But I have not regretted it. You like Possum Springs? It is beautiful in ways perhaps invisible to those who have seen it every day of their lives. So what happened to Ferdinand? He returned home and complained that the sky felt heavy. He had been up into the clouds. And now they rested hard upon him. That is a really specific complaint. When one leaves a place, one brings something back when one returns. One. Whew. That is all for the day. That was nice. Eh. Pretty sweet, the stars, I mean. Pretty sweet, the stars, I mean. I am in agreement. Well, the stars. Yep. May, you should go home and get in bed. Nah. At least come down through the house, so you don't break your neck falling off the roof. I'm good. I will watch you go, and call the ambulance if needed. Thanks, that's really nice. Least I can do. I will not fall, and I will not break my legs. See, I can fall from huge heights.
Hey, May. You alright?
Yeah, I guess. Why?
You look like you went through the dryer on the wrong setting.
Yeah. Long week is all.
You want to hear a poem cheer you up?
Sure.
Life goes on. It feels so long. But I report, life's too short.
Haha. Here's another happy one.
Life's great, but life's hard. Let's grill hot dogs in the backyard.
Thank you, Selmers.
They cheer you up?
They did. Yay!
Chizikov's up there again.
You ever, like, drop that telescope?
Oh no, he'd cry his eyes out. He loves that thing more than his kid.
He has a kid?
Yeah, name's Colin. Visits every once in a while. He's hot as hell.
You talk to him?
Nah, he works at some university research place. He's not interested in this.
Selmers.
They do karaoke at Miller's, but only like twice a week. Should be every night.
Karaoke can be cool. Bad weather's coming soon. I feel it in my bones. Alright, man. Pork. Shit. Okay. Right, let's get in here again. When mom asked me to help her out now, I will. Wait. There's nothing new ever on that board. Or I'm just not seeing it. Bet some red babies would love a delicious pretzel. Okay, let's do this again. Look away. Fairly easy now.
Yep.
Let's see if there's anyone here. Any specific things that triggered, maybe? Oh. So, like, are you always together?
Yeah, I guess.
That's cool. Friends are cool. Safer.
Safer?
Yeah, I like the buddy system. Safety in numbers.
You're a little paranoid, you know that?
Kit, you don't even know. Anyone hear anything about anyone around here missing?
Yeah, actually. There's some girl I know online. She hasn't been on since Harfest.
Okay, well, I think we might need a little more than that.
Okay.
Is she from here? Could ask my aunt.
Some place called Mulvey?
Mulvey? You know someone from Mulvey?
Yeah?
Do you know where Mulvey is? Do you know what Mulvey is?
No.
I heard about Mulvey. My dad drives a bread truck. Mulvey used to be one of his stops.
What happened?
He don't stop there no more. They had to pay some other guy to do it.
Sounds about right. What's Mulvey?
I'll take you out there this weekend.
Don't.
It'll be fine. We'll just drive through.
I need to go get back in the sun now. Alright. And we're going back. We're coming back. I'm gonna go, like, in a reverse order. So, Greg, Angus, and then B. Since Greg was the furthest away from my house. No, we already have one. Or do we need, like, two now, because we're...
Yeah.
So, yeah. I think that's... I don't know. I don't know why, because I'm still going to go past Greg's house. Greg's workplace, I mean. I'm still gonna go everywhere, so. Ha. I will see about helping Mom out, though. If that's the thing we're going to do, then that's what we're going to do. Hey, hon. Are you still having headaches? Yeah, but being out and about helps. Fresh air. Thanks for visiting me here, hon. It brightens my day. Feels weird being here today. Like, there's so much empty space. Come on Sunday. It's full then. I bet it is. Sorry you have to work because we have money problems. May, I've always had a job. This is just another one. Gotta get back to work, sweetie. See you, mombers. See you, daughters. Let's see if there's anything here, or anyone here. Oh, there's a whole crowd here. Because there will be children here.
And this is a historic church.
That's half empty.
That's your job to fix, not ours.
The population drain in this region. You have to know this place never will be full again. We have the space, and we have people who need space. We have resources, and we have poverty. Not in some far-off place or some big city. Right here. Right across the street. Karen, it's our number one job right now, to bring business into town. Businesses means jobs, and jobs means people. We have to do what we can to get the attention of the market. And having a half-dead church stacked full of bums... Thanks for your time. We'll see you for the vote tomorrow night. Thank you, Karen. You have a good heart, Karen. Thank you all for coming. Wow. Fuck you, people. Stressful day. Some days you need grace more than others. Was this all about Bruce? It was. Is. Whatever, it's out of our hands now. But there are better hands than mine. Anyway, how are you, May? Sounds serious. I guess. So, like, things have been rough lately. I can see that. What seems to be the trouble? I think I met God. What? It was a dream, but God talks to us that way, right? Sure. Can you tell me about it? It was like the shore of this giant black ocean. I could see like forever into the sky, and below it was just sand, as far as I could see. I was wandering through it, but I was like drawn to something. And I came up over this... what do you call a hill made of sand?
A dune?
Yeah, a dune. And there was God, just sitting there up on another hill, or dune, or whatever. Just hanging out? Yeah. Seemed like they were really into just hanging out.
Did they say anything?
Yeah. They were kind of a... They, like, didn't care. They didn't care if you were there? No, I mean, they didn't care in general. They went on about how annoyed they were, that people kept coming to them with questions, and annoyed that anyone thought they were God to begin with. Well, I don't think there was God, then. Why?
If something tells you it isn't God, you should probably believe it.
No, what I mean is that the thing we call God isn't God. It's just a thing, and it doesn't care. They kept talking about how this giant hole in the center of everything, growing. That sounds very lonely. Have you been feeling lonely lately? Yes. I had this problem when I was in high school. And I did something really bad. You probably heard about it. Your mom has mentioned it.
Yeah, I figured.
Well, since then, there's this deep down loneliness. Been there for years. Since, well, it's been a long time.
I've been there. I mean, I'm there all the time. I think that's where, if we open ourselves up, God can enter our lives most effectively. I don't think I believe in God anymore. If you want the truth, I think everyone doesn't believe in God for at least a few minutes a day. Faith is a process. You have to keep getting up and choosing to go on. Do you really think there is a God? Like, literally someone up there listening? Is that something you completely believe? I don't know. Oh. On my best days, I think I do. But there are times where I don't. But you stand up there every Sunday and tell people you do. And even you're not sure? It's your job to believe. Well, I think it's more my job to serve others. But you're lying to people. How? You stand up there and tell people to believe in something you don't 100% believe in yourself. Maybe you're right, May. And maybe I should get up there every week and give some sort of tally of how much I believe that week. But who would that help? But you're a pastor. And you can't tell me whether or not there's a God up there? Whether anyone is watching? Anyone who gives a shit? No, but... Then what is the point of you? I have to go. Okay. Oh, come on, May. That's unfair. She's just being honest. And I think that's the best way you can possibly... I mean, no... Yeah. I think people that believe, it's faith. You can't 100% know for sure anything. I am more on the don't believe side of the spectrum, though I've been raised Christian, but... Yeah. At least respect people that can be honest about it themselves, and... I'd never tell somebody they're believing in a fairy tale. That's very disrespectful, I think.
Hey, can you do me a favor?
Sure.
You tell Pastor Kate something for me.
Sure.
But don't tell her this till tomorrow. Can you do that?
Sure.
Tell her I said thank you, and I'm sorry it caused her trouble, but I'm not worth throwing away her job. She's the pastor, after all. Folks need her.
Are you leaving?
Yep. Gonna hop a train tonight. Headed east.
Where will you go?
Going home.
Wow, really?
Never gonna touch a bottle again. Never gonna lift a hand to no man again. Sit in my daughter's front porch, watch my grandbabies play in the yard. They'll all be there. I'm gonna get off that train. My kids are gonna be there. They'll have a sign they made. They'll have a fancy poster board and markers. Welcome home, Dad. And I'll be home.
That sounds great, Bruce.
Yep, yep. Thanks for talking to me. It was nice to get to know you.
You too, Bruce. Gonna miss you.
We'll all meet again.
I hope so.
Hope's important.
It's the last thing you got. You take care of yourself.
You too, May. I'll be fine, you know. I'm an old hand at this. Maybe older than I should have ever got to. But I'll be fine.
See you around, Bruce.
Goodbye, May.
Aw. Well, at least he's not just leaving because he's not welcome. He's leaving to a better situation in general. That's okay, I guess. I do really want to tell Karen now, though. To stop her stressing out about this. But, on the other hand, I promised Bruce I wouldn't tell until tomorrow. So I'm gonna tell tomorrow. If people don't want me to divulge information, I guess it's not my right to do that. Alright. Ah, that hit the spot. Alright. Let's go and feed the red babies. Probably four now. Thank you.
right. Right. Let's see. Is there anything here that's worth anything? Okay. Nothing. No, I guess. Right, babies. All right, my little miracle rats. Time to eat. Wow, there's so many of you. Someday you won't need me anymore, and you'll leave. Will I even recognize you on the street as we pass each other? I love you, miracle rats. All the achievements. That's the sole reason I do this. I'm an achievement whore. Oh, fuck. Yeah. Just do this here again. Still up here? I mean, I left and I went to work and so forth since we met. Is that a fiddle? It's a violin? That's like the same thing, right? It is a violin, I assure you. Fiddle and a violin, they are the same thing, right? Hey kid, what you up to? Hey adult, nothing. Sounds good. Just gonna go down to the tracks. Did you wanna come? No, I'm like tired right now. Right now? Like at this point in my life. Maybe some other time. It's cool. See ya. Bye. I'm sorry, kid. I already had plans for the day. Very specific. Yeah, okay, cool. Very specific plans to chill out with people. Angus, mostly. Hey, B. Hey. You're right. You seem down. Oh, it's nothing. Stuff. You want to talk about it? Nah. Okay. What are you up to today? Wandering around town. Have fun. Okay. Angus might be good for a bit longer. I'm gonna go around and do beef. Do? Hang out with B first. If Angus is good too, then I see no reason to chill out with him. Right now, I mean, I just...
Hey, May.
Hey, dude! Totally, what's up?
Nothing.
You okay?
Yup.
Okay.
Sorry, don't mind me.
What? Okay. You're not in a great mood, I see. Aren't we going to do the thing? Let's see if there's anything else up there. We gonna... They not fixed the button yet. No, not what I meant to do. I wanted to jump. Huh. Drugs and malt. So I says to her, maybe Mabel, get off the dang table. And she goes, why? Don't you just climb up here with me? No way. It's true. We both danced on that table. Nearly broke the damn thing. Somehow I can't see it. Well, you had to be there. I really didn't. I'm good. Alright. Let's one more time and go the other way. There's so much to see in this town. Really awesome game that they made everything so interactable. It's something I really enjoy, though I can see it maybe getting... Ah, fuck. Maybe for other people it would get annoying to... To an extent. Okay, let's go say hi to the crow buddy. Hey! Hey, Angel.
This is my friend, May.
Hey, May, what's up? Cool name.
Gracias, much obliged.
Angel's just in town.
Angel's just in town between trains.
I think I gave him that voice before.
Going west next.
Next?
Going west next?
Yeah, then south for the winter. Like a dirty birdie. Down to the Gulf. Lay in the sun. Eat me some crawfish. Actually, Angel, you might be able to answer a question. Shoot, bro. Have you met anyone named Casey out in the rails?
Let me think.
You know what he or she looked like? He looked kind of like me. A little taller, orangish hair.
No, man. I don't recollect. Was he like 1,000 dudes out there?
It's okay.
Tell you what. I'll ask around, and if I find him, or someone who's seen him, I'll say that May from Possum Springs is looking for him.
Thanks. That means a lot. I owe you.
Nah.
It's a cold world. Run by the worst people. Good men die for God knows what reason. We gotta take on, like, duties for one another, you know?
Yeah.
Thanks again. What's traveling like?
It's good, it's good. Near could stay in one spot.
I have, like, the exact opposite problem.
Alright, partners. Time for me to shove off. See ya, Angel.
I don't know. Stay safe.
Adios. Well, that's over.
No fun?
No fun. Something's bad's coming.
I know. It's a ghost, Germ. Real life ghost. There aren't ghosts. Ghosts aren't a thing. How do you know? My brother would have visited. Oh, that's me. Jeez. Well, dinner time. See ya. That was sucky. That was not fun. Where did Angel go off to? Boom. All right. Guess we'll go to Snake Falcon, say hi to Greg, and then go to B. Because I ain't leaving my friend feeling all shitty. This is not going to be a dilemma unless Greg is also feeling very off.
Sup, duder?
Hey!
How you holding up?
Surviving. Had the weirdest dream last night.
Really?
Saw some space bugs. No, not space bugs. Like, not bugs. And not in space. Like things beyond bugs. In some place beyond space.
I fell asleep on the couch watching Judge Kathy.
Oh, awesome. She's the best.
She really is.
She takes no crap.
Boy, you ain't lying. So what's up?
Just checking in.
You have checked in officially. I checked thee.
Yeah, no, I'm not gonna hang out with a friend that needs it less than one of my best friends. Though I hope I don't make it worse like I did last time. Because I kind of did. I guess I'm not going to do any of the, either of the things, like the graveyard or anything.
What are you up to today?
Whatever you want to do. Proximity. All right.
So what kind of party is this?
A Jackie party?
What's a Jackie party? You remember Jackie? Yeah, she's intense. She's serious about serious stuff. She's a lot of fun otherwise. Anyway, this is a party. And Jackie invited me. Look at you! Not going to secret parties and shit. They're not secret, May.
Well, I wasn't invited.
Okay, I invite you. You are now invited. Woo! Okay, we got like a 90-minute drive ahead, so... Jeez, this better be some party. Jackie, parties are worth the trip. Better put some music on, though. I think I went here once. In Girl Scouts. To see some sort of longest night play. Yeah, I was there. Oh yeah, we were kind of stuck together back then. Why'd you start talking to me? I was new in town, and you seemed cool. That's it? You were smart and fun. What am I now? You know, fun. It's like super shitty that you keep saying I'm not smart. I'm sorry, I'm mostly kidding. Mostly. You're not smart either. I was valedictorian of our class. Like that means anything in the real world. Sorry. Alright, let's go. I'm kinda nervous about this. Stay close, alright? Nothing to be scared of down here. Just a party. Not too late to throw ourselves into traffic instead. Hey, Jackie!
AB! Oh, weird, it's May!
Hey, Jackie! You brought May!
Yeah, is that okay?
Sure, it'll be fun! Come on in, it's a good one! Is there like dancing and stuff?
The world is ending, May!
Of course there's dancing!
Cool.
Okay! I'm not gonna make a fool out of myself. I hope. I really hope.
That's why you gotta take it seriously. Put your foot down. No fascists at this party.
Right. You don't talk the shit out. You punch the shit out. Do you think that's best?
Yeah.
Carry a knife and learn how to throw a punch. We can't have no sense of humor about this shit.
Mace works too.
Mace against fascists! Hey! Hey, this is May. Hey, May!
Yep, that's May.
So, where are you guys from?
Suburban Bright Harbor.
Couple of born and bred harbor rats.
Wow, what are you doing out here?
Long story for both of us.
I got time.
Hold up, we're gonna go yell at the DJ real quick.
We know him, he's a total dink.
Okay, I'll be here.
Bye, boys!
They seem nice. This is very cool.
No drinking, May.
Okay, fine.
You guys wanna dance?
Yeah! Can you dance, May? Can, like, anyone here dance?
It's like a fucking doggy pedal, what they're doing. That's not a dance. Oh, look at the little limp arms. Love it. Oh, yeah. I love it. Oh, dude, I can even control the dancing. Oh, this is my jam, man. Okay, let's not do that. Overly sexual. Twerking.
Hey, I think those guys are back over there. Or back over there. Oh, yeah. Should we go talk to them? Yeah, we should. I can dance! I never knew! I'm gonna keep dancing. Are you sure? Yeah, I don't think I've danced at a party before. Okay, we'll be like 10 feet away with an eye shot, and I'll watch you. Don't drink anything someone gives you. B, I know. No, seriously, if any... B, I'll be fine. Let's go, she'll be fine. Okay. Oh man, that's an intense voice to do. Nah, fuck it, let's twerk. Is someone gonna come? So this is my life now. It's not very rhythmic, is it? Dancing is easy. What's the big fuss? Hey, you. Hey, you. Do I know you?
Nope. What's your name?
Samantha Stevenson.
Samantha. I like it. It sounds like a magic spell.
You found me out. It was magic. And now you're good and hexed.
Wow.
So what's your story, Samantha Stevenson? I'm a grad student studying vampires and play bass.
Wow, that's interesting.
I mean, it's just a regular bass guitar.
Nothing special about it?
Got it for my 16th birthday. It's got my blood on it.
Is that a problem with vampires?
Yeah, they totally covet that shit.
That's pretty cool.
I guess. I guess I'm so used to awesome stuff that I'm pretty cool in most situations.
Oh, really?
Hey, give me your hand. Oh, all right.
What are we doing?
Oh, wow.
Secret handshake.
Wow.
Wow. It worked. Wow, okay. Okay, I should go find my friend. Let her know I'm over here. Oh yeah, you should. Samantha.
Ah, hexed again. Boom.
I'll be here.
Wow, okay. Be right back.
All right. Nobody here.
So I got a secret thing. Hey, B. Oh, hey, May. This is Chris. Hey, Chris.
Hey.
Your friend B is pretty cool. Aw, she's okay. You're laughing a lot. Beatrice. That's like an old name. Like a book you read in second grade. Well, a book you liked. I like ghost stories. My granddad died. Left me an apple crate full. Sorry about your granddad. It's okay, it was years ago. Oh, fuck you. May, stop. I'm sure everyone here knows someone who died. My dog died last spring. My house exploded. Because there was a gas leak. From when my dad hit a line. Trying to dig up the dog we had before that. Because we were going to move. And Dad said he had to come with us.
Wow.
So Chris, what are you majoring in? Poli science. Oh, that's cool. Are there like a lot of jobs in that? I don't know. I just find it interesting. I feel like you have to be pretty materialistic to go to college just so you can get a job after. That's interesting because... Whoa. Check out Rich Kid over here. Gonna pay zillions of dollars to go to college just cause something's interesting? Baby, check this dude out! You ever worked a day in your life, Chaz? I interned at my uncle's firm, yes.
Well, I bagged groceries.
Okay. Mate, you wanna dance some more? Sure. You should go dance.
Yeah, my parents own their own business, so...
Ooh, tell me about it. I know a bit about running a small business. Wanna go across the street and get some pizza? I can eat. It's a small business.
You'll speak their language. Get us free slices.
Fuck you, May. B doesn't like spoiled rich kids, Chuck.
I'll come along if that's okay, B.
Yeah, let's go. Okay. B knows all about business. She's super on top of things. Super smart and responsible. She feels like the biggest store in Possum Springs. May, no. What even is Possum Springs? It's west in the mountains. While rich kids over here studying politicians or whatever, B's out in the real world. Not like you college kids.
May!
What? I'm kind of over the whole college thing myself. I mean, I basically run Possum Springs. Except there's like a ghost or something.
Did you live in Possum Springs?
Yeah, you got a problem with that?
Wow, you drove all the way here from Deep Hollow County? Isn't that like 2 hours away?
No,
why would you do that?
Hey Rick, B here drove in from Deep Hollow.
Are you not a student?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, I am. I'm...
B, wait!
What was that about?
I think she doesn't go here.
So?
Dude, I don't even know.
Oh, fuck. I ruined it for her. I'm an asshole.
What did you do?
I was gonna ask the same thing.
How in the world did you mess that up?
She needs this. Now she's God knows where.
If something happens to her, I will personally punch her teeth out.
Okay, jeez.
All right, I'm gonna go up the street. You go down towards the river. We find her, make sure she's okay, and meet back here.
Okay. Oh, God. Okay.
Back in school, I always told B that you were an asshole. I really thought that was true. It's good to know I was right. Fucking hell.
Okay. Where are you, B? Roofs. Can't get to the river quick on the roofs. Hey, move!
What?
Move it, goth dorks.
No.
I need to get up on the roof. You are not jumping on my car. I will end you right here in this pizza place parking lot.
You cool down.
You F off. Don't tell me to F off. Don't tell me to cool down.
Get away from my damn car.
If you don't get away from your damn car, I'm gonna run it over your damn head. Can you even drive?
Wanna find out, citizen?
I'm gonna call the cops. If you don't move right now, I'm gonna probably make you eat this entire car. And I can do it. I'd like to see you try.
The last person I hurt, physically, I hurt him very, very badly. Physically.
Seriously, I'm about to... You're about to what? You know what? I don't have time for this.
No, you don't. Move.
Hope you break your spine.
Oh, God.
God damn it. I fucking messed this up. I'm not a good friend, really. Or May isn't. Not a good wing woman. Oh, shit. This works too. Whatever works to get there quickest. B! There you are. Are you alright? Why'd you run? That's like extremely dangerous. You're alone in some college town. And you don't even know what... This was my party. These are my parties.
I come to these so I can feel normal for like 2 hours a month. You could have been like mugged or something. All over some idiot guy. College is stupid anyways. Oh my god, you complete asshole. You'll never understand this. Ever. You know what I do when I go to sleep? This is so freaking sad. I think, like, obsessively about going to college. Like, really, really think hard about it. And if I'm lucky, as I fall asleep, I dream about it. I have to dream about this. This is a thing you're so over already. It's like my wildest fantasy. You have a life. No, I don't. I have obligations. I have a routine. When my mom died, my life ended too. I had to take over the business because Dad had a complete breakdown. And the bills for my mom literally dying were so bad that we lost the house. The house I grew up in. Gone. Some shitty family with their shitty kids live there now. Now we live in an apartment as my dad wastes away. And like any idea I had of the future, this big, bright thing just gets smaller and darker every time I wake up from a dream about nights like tonight. And you can't get that through your thick effing skull. I had no idea about any of this. How? How could you not know this? I work hard, and I take care of what's left of my family. And my life is slipping away. And I'm trapped in that stupid hardware store. In that stupid town. I'm just doomed. You're not the only person stuck here, you know. You gave up the thing I can't have. I kinda hate you. I can't not hate you for that a little. You don't know why I had to leave. Oh, I'm sure it's a brilliant reason. You just sit there judging me. Have you ever asked why I left? Yeah, first day you were back. Oh, right. So why did you leave? Fucking hell. I don't know. My head is in pieces right now. Any answer I would give, could give, would sound nuts. Oh. Well, that's illuminating. Oh, shut up. All this shit going on this past week. Ghosts and shit. I met God. He was an asshole. Look. We're both trapped. But we're trapped together. Better not be trapped with someone else. Better to be trapped with someone else, right? Listen, I'm sorry about, like, it's okay. We're, like, the best available friends. Oh, God. What river is this? Red Winder? All the iron in the water turns the rocks orange. Must be weird for them. All the rocks on land get to keep their colors, and the river rocks are always looking up at them. There's a metaphor there. So, like, actual question. Do you think we'd be friends if we weren't, like, stuck together in the same town? Like we were stuck together in Girl Scouts? Like, is this just, what's the word? Proximity? Yeah. I don't know. I honestly don't. My entire life feels like running after something that keeps moving away into the distance while I stay in the same place. And I guess proximity counts for a lot right now. Proximity. You want to go back to the party? Nah. We can come to another one sometime. I'll learn to talk good to whatever guy you're obviously trying to get with. Oh, good. Thanks. B, you should have told me about everything. I was embarrassed. My entire life is embarrassing. B, I'm, like, more embarrassing than you'll ever be. You are, like, stronger and smarter than everyone I've ever met. Thanks. And you're not as big a total idiot as I act like you are. I'm a jerk sometimes, I know that. But you're genuinely... You're a genuinely good person? I'll take it. You know what the... You know what the FT... The CN Fish Fountain would say? What?
Beatrice Santello!
We should get burgers and shakes on the way home. Oh.
We should get burgers and shakes on the way home.
Oh, wow, a revelation from God. The good God, the fake one. Crap, I didn't get her info. Who? This super cute girl I met at the party. Oh, that was a girl. Shit. I thought I was a very dandy man. We did a secret handshake. Is that a euphemism? Crap. Yeah, we need to come back. Okay, you. Let's go home. Home again, home again. Hey.
Hello. Oh, wow, are you okay?
No.
Okay. So what's going on?
I don't think I can talk about it.
You're gonna have to start talking sometime, kid.
I wish I could.
Why can't you?
Where to even start? It's just... I've been having these dreams, and I keep thinking I see a ghost.
A ghost?
And I've had these horrible nightmares that feel really real. And I think something really bad is going to happen. And I've been running around doing all this stupid stuff. And where is it all going? What even is my life right now? I think I patched up some stuff tonight. But, like, everyone is on their way somewhere else. And I had that big fight with Mom.
Kitten, it's okay.
And that's not even counting the money problems.
Yeah. Money problems make everything worse. I know it.
And I can't do anything about it. I don't even know if I could hold down a job. And how am I ever going to survive? And...
Shh, kitten. Take a breath.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
Why don't you get some sleep?
Can I just stay down here for a bit?
As long as you like. Oh god, I'm not gonna have to do those voices again!
Mallory!
Garbo?
Ever think about it, you know? The afterlife?
I don't have a life. I don't have a life as it is!
Why, Garbo? Do you think there's someone up there watching?
Hey, I just hope anyone's not watching at this time slot.
These are the big questions, Garbo.
Don't get any bigger, Mallory.
Are you a churchgoer, Garbo?
Hey, the last time I was in church... Oh, this is a very different voice.
Ah! The last time I was in church, they hadn't invented religion yet.
No, you're making it up as we went along.
Okay, so we all think there's a god, right?
We should have potlucks. Can't have church without potlucks.
You could, Mallory. But it would be... a whoopa!
I don't fucking know. I don't get these... Okay.
Coming up next, Garbo and I contact the dead.
There needs to be some kind of film theory or game theory on this, like how everything ties together. Because there's a lot of metaphors, a lot of subliminal stuff going on, you know? And no dialogue. Okay.
Righto. Let's see if anyone wants to chat tonight.
Hey, you.
Hey, me. I am so tired from tonight. I bet. Did you run all the way to the river?
Yeah, on the roofs and stuff. That and dancing really takes it out of you.
That's like really... That's really nice, me, that you did that.
No, it wasn't nothing.
Go get some sleep. Okay, I'll do that. Thanks for running after me.
Oh, I never go away. You'll never be rid of me.
I can think of worse fates.
Aww. Hey, kid. Went to a party. Danced at a party. Ran around in the rain. Met a hot girl. Totally didn't get her number. She's a bombshell, though.
Wow, sounds like an awesome night.
It was a mixed bag. But all in all, I'd party again.
We need to do more parties.
You are very right. All right, I'm off to bed.
Laters.
Bedtime?
Yes.
All right, let's see if there's another vague fucking dream. The same way all the day. It's like... Oh shit, that was really the last dream. So, I guess we'll see what today brings in the next episode.
So, if you like this episode, give us a like and join me crew for more booty.
But now, off the plank with you!
A frigate sails a soul they tell from every corner of the realm, the mouse and keyboard of the helm, the mouth of the Playing Dutchman. Soon you'll all be singing the jaunty tune of the Playing Dutchman.